the little owl, moo the little owl.
Mo was a little owl. I don't mean that he was smaller than all the others, although he was, but a little owl was the kind of bird he was. He lived on a farm just down the road from the Shawfield cabins on the edge of the New Forest. Of all the owls who lived in Rosewood Barn at the farm, he was the smallest. When Tammy the tawny owl would swoop into the barn like a jet plane, he would hide out of the way. When Brian the barn owl would blink his huge dinner plate eyes, Mo would look the other way. When Sally the snowy owl would whoosh out of the barn like a flurry of snow on her magnificent white wings, he would wait for a quieter moment to take his short flight. Mo's place was a corner of the oldest beam just to the side of the big barn door. Above it was a little hole in the old roof where he could see the stars, and below it was a pile of straw, which was his favourite place in the whole farm. The reason he loved it so was that this was the place where Jenny, the farmer's daughter, would come to play. Sometimes she would build castles in the straw and gaze out from their ramparts. Other times she would lie down on the straw, turning the pages of a storybook. Recently, though, she'd been bringing a visitor with her. Patch was a little ball of fluff, the youngest puppy of the litter born to the farmer's sheepdog. She was black and white and her fur stood out in all directions. She hadn't quite learnt to wag her tail yet, and sometimes it would just twitch when she was least expecting it. Every time it happened, Jenny would laugh and Mo, unseen up in the rafters, would hoot. Jenny had been coming more often to the barn recently. Patch was not really growing up the way she ought to, and she couldn't run around with her brothers and sisters. Sometimes she would just curl up in Jenny's lap, looking up from time to time when her tail did its little twitching dance. One day, when Patch was especially glum, Jenny was reading her a story as she lay curled up in her lap. There was something about the sound of her voice and the pictures in the storybook that just made Mo want to join in, and he flew down from his perch to be a little nearer. Poor Mo. He didn't mean it to happen. Just as he got halfway down, Patch did a tail twitch, Mo hooted with laughter, and without looking, he crashed into the doorpost, bounced off it, and landed in a heap of crumpled feathers on the straw next to Jenny. Gently, ever so gently, Jenny dusted Mo off and set him on the straw beside her. Once, twice, three times, he blinked his bright yellow eyes and wondered what would happen next. Can you guess what it was? Jenny picked up the storybook and read to her audience of two, a crumpled owl and a poorly puppy. Every day after that, she would come to the barn with Patch and her storybook, and Mo would fly down to join them. He was more careful now and didn't hit the doorframe once. Patch was weaker now, and her tail rarely twitched, but she still loved the stories and listened carefully until a giant puppy yawn overcame her and she went to sleep. After that, it was many days until Jenny came back to the barn. When she did, she was all alone. She had no storybook, and her eyes were all red as if she'd been crying. Mo hopped, two shuffles to the left, two shuffles to the right. What should he do? In the end, he spread his little stubby wings and flew down to land on the straw at Jenny's side. He looked at her with his bright yellow eyes. She looked at him with her tearful eyes. The two of them sat like that for a long, long time. The next day, when Jenny came back, Mo was waiting for her on the straw. He cocked his head on one side and hooted just quietly as she sat down. Out from under her arm, she took a storybook, Patch's favourite, and began to read. So far as I know, she still does it, every day. Mo doesn't hide in the roof anymore. Jenny doesn't cry so much. And Patch is never, ever forgotten. And there's another thing, too. On Jenny's wall, right beside a photo of Patch, there's a picture of an owl who looks just like Mo.
Mo the little owl, Mo the little owl.
Mo the Little Owl was written and narrated by Richard Littledale. Music by Elliot James Frisbee.